any important notes. Okay. So for today, okay, we are going to look for another subtopic. Okay, you have already learned about 2.1, okay, where you learn about the external and internal structure of the leaf. Okay, you learn the two external structure of the leaf, okay, which are lamina and petiole, and also you learn about the five main internal structure in the leaf. Okay, so now we are going to look what are the processes that can be done at leaf. Okay, as you already familiar, okay, before this, when you heard the word leaf, okay, it must be associated with the photosynthesis. Okay, but we are going to postpone. Okay, photosynthesis will be in the next subtopic. So for today, we are going to focus on the gaseous exchange, okay, that occur at the leaf. Okay, so for today lesson, okay, I don't think it will take a long time. Okay, so for I think maybe it will take about half an hour. Okay, and then I will give you an exercise, okay, via Google Form. Okay, just a simple objective question, okay, to test your understanding. Okay, as you already know, okay, the leaf has stomata. Okay, stomata is a pores, okay, that is located, okay, majority or abundance of stomata are located at the lower epidermis of the leaf. Okay, ada juga stomata yang berada di bahagian upper epidermis, tapi tak banyak berbanding dengan bahagian lower epidermis. Okay, jadi di bahagian lower epidermis of the leaf, okay, there is a specialized type of cell, okay, yang kita panggil sebagai guard cell. Okay, kita tahu guard cell, okay, the function of guard cell is to control opening and closing of stomata. Okay, guard cell tu selalunya dia akan dalam pair of guard cell. So ada dua pasang guard cell, okay, yang akan membantu to control the opening and closing of stomata. Okay, and the thing that you need to remember, okay, this specialized guard cell that is located at lower epidermis contain chloroplast. Okay, walaupun sebelum ni, okay, saya ada bagi tahu di bahagian lower epidermis, okay, there is no chloroplast. Okay, cuma ada epidermal cell. Okay, tapi untuk bahagian guard cell sahaja, dia akan mengandungi chloroplast. Okay, bila guard cell tu ada chloroplast, so secara logiknya dia adalah untuk proses fotosintesis. Okay, so ingat ya, the thing that you need to remember for gaseous exchange, the first thing is stomata. Okay, it's a pores that is controlled by a pair of guard cell. Okay, second thing is guard cell. Okay, and located at majority, located at the lower epidermis, and guard cells contain chloroplast for the process of photosynthesis. So now we are going to look, okay, what are some of the conditions, okay, that allow the guard cell or stomata to open and close. So based on the slide, okay, you can see tak banyak ya. Okay, that based on your syllabus, okay, what you need to remember, okay, there are two conditions that allow whether the guard cells need to be closed or open. Okay, the first condition or factor, the intake or uptake of potassium ion, K plus ion. Okay, and the second factor or condition is the sucrose concentration. Okay, sucrose is a type of sugar. Okay, this is jenis sugar lah. Okay, yang dihasilkan apabila habisnya proses fotosintesis. Okay, okay, so first, okay, we are going to look at the uptake of potassium ion by guard cell. Okay, maksudnya potassium ion ni akan diserap masuk, diambil masuk ke dalam guard cell. Okay, then you look at the first point. Okay, the accumulation or elimination of potassium ion in the gut cell will changes the solute potential. Okay, solute potential ni adalah kandungan solute lah. Okay, dan kandungan solute, okay, solute potential, dia akan ada kaitan dengan water potential. Okay, bila solute potential high water potential in the guard cell will be low. Jadi hubungan di antara solute potential dan juga water potential adalah berlawanan. So kamu kena ingat balik chapter I think it was in chapter 3. Okay, form 4. Okay, the movement across the plasma membrane. Okay. Tapi okay, these differences of solute and water potential will cause either the water to diffuse out or into the gut cell, okay, by the process of osmosis. Okay, when you write down the word water, diffuse in or diffuse out, okay, you must, after you write down water diffuse in, into or outside of the cell, okay, you must write down the word osmosis. Okay, do not forget. Okay, perkataan water frasa, frasa water diffuse in or out mesti dituruti, okay, mesti diikuti dengan perkataan osmosis. Okay, supaya dia ada nampak sebab kita tahu, okay, perkataan osmosis ni adalah sangat penting. Okay, dia nak menunjukkan water, cara apa water dia, water ni bergerak. Okay, by the process of osmosis. Okay, bila ada perkataan water, okay, you must write down the word osmosis. Okay, kadang-kadang dalam skema, okay, it will have two different marks. Okay, when you mention about water diffuse in or out, one mark, by osmosis is considered another one mark. Sebab itulah saya suruh kamu tulis perkataan osmosis. Sebab dia adalah, dia akan membawa markah yang berbeza. Okay, bergantung kepada skema lah. Okay. Okay, so whether the water diffuse in or out, okay, this will cause whether the guard cell, okay, to be turgid or flaccid. Okay, so when there are more water diffuse into the guard cell, lebih banyak water molecules masuk, diffuse, serap ke dalam guard cell by osmosis, so the guard cell will be turgid. Okay, kalau dalam bahasa Malaysia, tak silap saya, dia panggil sekah, tak silap. Okay, tak, okay, tak pasti sangat. Okay, dia akan turgid, maksudnya dia akan jadi kembang lah sebab guard cell tu dipenuhi dengan water. Okay, but the vice versa will happen when a lot or many water molecule diffuse out from the gut cell. So when the water molecule diffuse out from the gut cell, so the gut cell will lose its turgidity. Okay, dia akan hilang dia punya turgidity dan akan jadi flaccid. Dia akan jadi lembek. Okay, dia lembek, so the stoma will close. close. Apa ni kita akan tengok lebih lagi eh. And then the next is we will be looking at the sucrose concentration in the guard cell. Okay, as I mentioned before, the guard cell contain chloroplast. Okay, so when the guard cell contain chloroplast, logically it will perform photosynthesis, and one of the product of photosynthesis is sucrose. Okay, jadi bila guard cells ni dah ada chloroplast, okay, walaupun guard cell ni terletak di bahagian epidermis, dan secara general epidermal cell does not contain chloroplast, okay, tapi guard cell has chloroplast. So when the guard cell has chloroplast, the guard cell will undergo the process of photosynthesis in the presence of light. Jadi bila berlakunya proses photosynthesis, the guard cell will be accumulated. Okay, akan dipenuhi dengan sucrose. Okay, sebab sucrose adalah salah satu produk daripada proses photosynthesis. Okay, pada waktu siang lah. Okay, dan apabila waktu malam, okay, during the night, okay, the sugar, okay, which is sucrose in the guard cell, okay, will be converted into starch. Okay, akan ditukar kepada starch, ya. Okay, this is a general, okay, general overview, okay, of the two conditions, okay, that affect the opening and closing of stomata. So now we are going to look at the mechanism. Okay, mechanism ni melibatkan dia punya pergerakan lah. Okay, macam mana stomata ni terbuka dan juga tertutup. Okay, first we look at the opening of stoma. Okay, as you can see on the on figure 2.2, okay, there are three pictures. Okay, three pictures. Okay, on the left hand side, okay, yang di sebelah kiri, okay, it shows that the stomata is closed. Okay, and you can see the tiny red dots represent potassium ion. Okay, so it's closed stomata, then around the guard cell, okay, there are tiny potassium ion. Okay, so when the guard cell increase the uptake, pengambilan of potassium ion, okay, this will cause the solute potential in the guard cell to increase. Okay, maksudnya concentration of solute dalam guard cell tu akan jadi lebih tinggi berbanding di luar guard cell. Okay, maksudnya bukannya guard cell tu akan ambil semua potassium ion. Tak. Okay, so kalau kamu tengok diagram, lebih banyak potassium ion yang berada dalam guard cell berbanding di luar. Okay. So when there are more potassium ions inside the guard cell, this will cause the solute potential to be increases. Okay. Dan macam yang saya cakap tadi, when the solute potential is increases, the water potential will decrease. Okay, dia akan berlawanan. Okay, dia tak boleh solute potential tinggi, water potential pun tinggi. Okay, takkan jadi macam tu. Okay, dia mesti when the solute potential increase and vice versa will happen. Okay, the water potential will decrease. Okay. Jadi macam mana ini, kamu punya guard cell ni nak seimbangkan balik air? Okay, nak seimbangkan balik water potential. So apa yang guard cell tu buat adalah the guard cell will allow the water molecule to diffuse into the guard cell. Okay, disebabkan kandungan air dalam guard cell tu dah jadi rendah. Okay, jadi guard cell ni akan buka pintu dia. Okay, bagi dia punya plasma membrane dia tu jadi permeable to water for diffuse into the guard cell. Okay, by the process of osmosis. Okay, so when a lot of water diffuse into the guard cell by the process of osmosis, the guard cell will become turgid. Okay, dia akan jadi sekah. Okay, dia akan jadi mengembang macam tu, and curve outwards. Jadi bila the guard cell will become turgid, so logically the stoma will open. Okay, disebabkan banyaknya air yang masuk ke dalam guard cell, the guard cell becoming turgid, and then the stoma will open. Okay. So when the stoma open, the rate of water loss is higher lah. Sebab lebih banyak air yang akan dapat keluar melalui stoma tu ya. Okay, next we look at the sucrose concentration. So in the presence of light, okay, bila adanya cahaya matahari, okay, selalunya pada waktu siang, okay, di waktu yang cahaya yang matahari yang banyak, okay, especially during the noon, okay, after tengah hari, okay, waktu pagi mungkin kurang sikit, proses photosynthesis will occur. Okay, banyaknya akan berlakunya proses photosynthesis. Okay, so when the process of photosynthesis occur, logically the concentration of sucrose will be higher in the guard cell. Okay, sebab guard cell yang ada chloroplast. Okay, di tepi-tepi guard cell yang epidermal cell yang nearby. Okay, nearby epidermal cell does not perform photosynthesis. Okay, sebab tak ada chloroplast kan. Okay, cuma guard cell yang lakukan proses photosynthesis. Okay, sebab guard cell ada chloroplast. Okay, Dan bila berlakunya banyak proses fotosintesis, okay, this will cause the concentration of sucrose is higher ataupun jadi lebih banyak. Okay, sebab kamu ingat guard cell in the presence of light buat proses fotosintesis, lebih banyak proses fotosintesis, lebih banyak sucrose concentration. Okay, sucrose concentration tu akan jadi lebih tinggi. Okay, so when the concentration of sucrose in the guard cell is high, benda yang sama yang berlaku di potassium ion, dia akan terbalik. Okay, water potential in the guard cell will be decreased. Okay, dia akan berlawanan. Okay, kamu ingat macam tu aja ya. Maksudnya bila concentration of potassium ion ataupun concentration of sucrose is high, so the water potential ataupun water concentration will be low ataupun decreases. Okay, so when the water potential decreases, jadi untuk nak seimbangkan balik antara, sebab kamu punya cells ni dia akan cuba untuk nak seimbangkan. Tak nak bagi ada satu kawasan yang terlebih ataupun satu kawasan yang kurangnya air. Okey, dia akan cuba untuk nak seimbangkan kandungan air dalam guard cell dan juga di luar guard cell. Okey. So when the water content inside the guard cell is decreased, okay, this will allow more water to diffuse into the guard cell by osmosis. Okay, bila perkataan water diffuse in or out, okay, mesti selepas kamu tulis perkataan tu mesti ada perkataan osmosis. Okay, so when the guard cells are filled with water, the guard cell will become turgid and curved outwards. Okay, dia akan jadi turgid, cekah dan akan curve outwards. Okay, dia akan membengkok keluar ya. Dan this will cause the stoma to open. Okay. Okay, so next we look at the closing of stoma. So basically, the opening and closing of stoma is the same point. Okay, if the question is coming out in your exam, you can basically remember either one. Okay, sama ada kamu nak ingat mengenai opening dan closing adalah yang terbalik, yang vice versa. Apa yang berlaku di opening of stoma. Okay. Okay. So we look at the first condition. Okay. Uptake of potassium ion. Okay. Sama juga. So when the potassium ion move out from the guard cell. Okay. Kalau kamu tengok diagram ni. Diagram yang ke, yang tengah-tengah. Okay. Bila potassium ion tu dah keluar daripada guard cell, lebih banyak potassium ion yang berada di luar guard cell. Okay, dalam guard cell ni dia akan ada juga potassium ion, tapi tak banyak. Okay, bila tak banyak, benda apa yang akan tinggi? Okay. So the water potential inside the gut cell will increase. Okay, sebelum tu the solute potential, okay, kandungan potassium ion dalam gut cell dia akan berkuranglah. Okay, disebabkan banyak yang keluar. Okay. Dan bila kandungan solute potential is decreased, the water potential will increases. Okay, dia akan berlawanan. Okay, solute potential and water potential are is in inverse relationship. Okay, when water potential is high, solute potential will be low. Okay, dia tak boleh nak dua-dua high ataupun dua-dua low. Okay, so when the water potential in the gut cells increases, okay, terlalu banyak air dalam gut cell tapi di luar gut cell ni sikitnya air. So the logically the water molecule will diffuse out from the gut cell to the nearby epidermal cell by osmosis. Okay, do not, please write down the word osmosis. So when the there are a lot of water diffused out from the gut cell by the process of osmosis, okay, so the gut cell will be flaccid. Okay, dia akan jadi lembek. Okay, disebabkan air dah banyak yang kurang, air dah banyak diserap keluar daripada gut cell, jadi gut cell tu dia akan jadi flaccid, dia akan jadi lembek. Okay, bila lembek, the stoma closes. Okay, stoma tu dia akan tutup lah. Okay. So basically the same mechanism is happening about sucrose concentration. Okay, cuma yang bezanya adalah sucrose. Okay. Tapi sucrose ni concentration dia ada kaitan dengan light. Okay, presence of light dan juga proses photosynthesis. Okay, tapi potassium ion does not influence by the process of photosynthesis or absence of light. Okay, sucrose concentration ni dia bergantung kepada proses photosynthesis. Okay. Okay, so now we are going to look at the sucrose concentration. So when the sunlight is absent, okay, especially during the night, okay, ataupun waktu-waktu yang dah nak dekat senja, okay, waktu-waktu yang dah nak dekat petang, less ataupun no photosynthesis occur. Okay, so when less photosynthesis is occur, the concentration of sucrose will be low inside the gut cell. Okay, you must write down the word inside the gut cell. Okay, sebab gut cell tu sahaja yang ada chloroplast. Okay, so when the sucrose concentration is low, benda apa yang akan jadi tinggi? The water potential will increase inside the gut cell. Okay, bila terlalu banyaknya air di dalam gut cell, so logically the gut cell will allow the water to diffuse out from the gut cell to the nearby epidermal cell, okay, by osmosis. Okay, dan benda yang sama yang akan berlaku di potassium ion. So when there are a lot of water is diffused out from the gut cell, so the gut cell will be flaccid. Okay, dia akan jadi flaccid lah. Okay, dia akan jadi lembek, and then the stoma will close. Okay, kamu ingat kataan tu je, terjit, when water diffuse into the gut cell. Okay, flaccid, when water diffuse out from the gut cell. Okay, this is some activity. Okay, maybe we can do. Okay, once you are coming back to MRSM, tahu tak bila kamu balik ke MRSM? Bila? Apa hari bulan?
5.
Oh, okay. 5 hari bulan ni kan. 5 bulan tu hari Senin. So, kamu mungkin akan datang sehari sebelum lah. Okay. Okay. Dalam sebulan lebih sikit lagi. Okay. Okay, so now we are going, okay, this subtopic, okay, it's not that so that much. Okay, the effect of water deficiency in plant on stomatal opening and closing. Okay, so as you can see on the left hand side, okay, di sebelah kiri ni fresh plants, okay, yang di sebelah kanan adalah wilted plants. Okay, wilted ni maksudnya layu. Okay, fresh, pohon yang segar. Okay, wilted adalah pohon yang layu lah. Okay. Okay, when the plant obtain enough water, okay, ni a fresh plant, the gut cell will become terjit. Okay, bila the plants obtain enough water, dia akan jadi terjit. Jadi the inner cell wall of the gut cell. So kalau kamu tengok diagram, okay, kamu tengok di bahagian tengah ni ya. Okay, this is a gut cell. Okay, dan gut cell ni is surrounded by epidermal cell. Dan kamu tengok di bahagian tengah tu, okay, bahagian stoma, kamu tengok the cell wall of the gut cell is thick compared with the outer cell wall. Okay, bahagian tengah gut cell dia lebih tebal berbanding di bahagian luar itu ya. Okay, so the thin and more elastic cell causes the gut cell to curve outwards and stomata to open. Okay, bila pohon tu segar, dia dapat banyak air, so the gut cell dia akan open lah. Okay, to reduce some water loss. Okay, tapi untuk wilted plant, okay, pohon yang dah layu, okay, logically the gut cell will be closed. Okay, sorry, the gut cell will be flaccid, so the stoma will close. Okay, sebab nak kurangkan the loss of water. Yalah, sebab bila dah pohon tu dah layu, okay, dah kekurangan air, jadi secara logiknya the stoma will close. Okay, to reduce the water loss. Okay, jelah kan kalau stoma tu buka nanti banyak pula air yang akan hilang. Okay, makin makin layu lah pokok tu ya. Okay. Okay, I think that's all. Okay, if you have any question, then nanti cikgu bagi link Google Form untuk kamu buat soalan objektif. Ada soalan nak tanya? Tak ada? No? Okay, okay, you can okay, you can dismiss now. Okay, you can go for your break. Okay, thank you. Assalamualaikum and good morning. Okay.